Welcome, everybody. This is Ecclesia Church as God intended. And we just started talking about, Cindy brought up a word that a lot of us have brought about the one of the how so important for us to be still and not be caught up in busyness in this hour. So we're just starting to discuss that and how we all need to enter into this rest. And I was just saying, I totally agree with Cindy on that, because I saw just the title of that and it resonated with me so strong. And I knew that, I just knew that was what, you know, he's been saying that, you know, to be still, to stay in rest, even before Passover. But this word that she gave was a warning, an exhortment not to be caught up into busyness. So, yeah, that was good. Let's see, maybe our mandate might be around this today. Did anybody else have a mandate, or is this resonating with anybody else?
I just wondered how that is in conjunction with ruling. You know, really, I mean, it goes on one more step farther to say we're to rule. But now that, you know, that really strikes me as how important it is to rule from rest as well.
Yes, we must rule from rest. That's right. Absolutely. Let's see. Yeah, it's very, very, very important. It's a lot in that, because it's important for us during this season to, you know, we've seen that, to know who we are so that we can walk in that and manifest that, you know, once we come out of this period of rest. We've seen that it's a serious time of receiving, it's a serious time of identity aligning, to get blueprints for the season ahead. It's a very pivotal time. So, yeah, and like Casey said, we must operate for rest. Really, you aren't really doing anything if you're not operating from rest. Because if you're not operating from rest, you're operating out of your own government. You're not operating out of the government of God.
That sounds like striving to me.
Yeah. Yeah, because to operate out of rest is to simply do what God is telling you to do. We present ourselves as a living sacrifice. And if he says to do it, we do it. If he says not to do it, we don't. It's really that simple. And that's how you get to stay out of overwhelm too. Because you get overwhelmed just trying to do stuff meaning well. But you get overloaded, because even though you're meaning well, you can end up doing stuff that you really weren't even supposed to carry or do. So, yeah, just that. But welcome, Cheryl, Sharon, Vance, and Laura. Anybody else got... and want to share anything on their heart, even if it's totally different from this?
Well, I have to say that it's just so amazing, because I just, every day it's eagles coming to me. And, you know, and even sometimes I guess I'm so into the eagles, I said, well, I guess I'll put on the eagle shirts I got, you know, and I just thank the Lord for it. And as I really just seek his face to find more and more about this eagles. But Carol did send me a word that was put out, that the Lord was actually releasing the eagles. And that was after the vision I had and the encounter. So I am seeking him for the how it translates into me, and how how do I fit in? Because I've been seeing eagles. I first started seeing when I was 20 years old, and I think I'm coming into it. I'm coming into the eagle. So if y'all see me on the encounter and I look like a bird, well, you know.
Awesome. Thank you, Lord. You know, one thing that she said that struck me in that word that we even saw on the encounter, I believe it was on Women's Arising. Do you all, I think it was the Women's Arising. Remember we saw the whale? And the whale was going deep. She mentioned the whale in this word too, I believe. Yeah, I think it was in here.
I think that was here with Patience. We did that whale, wasn't it?
That again, Casey?
I think that was here with Patience in this group. We did the whale.
Oh, was it this group? Okay, sorry. Thank you for correcting.
Thank you.
And I was just marking that she saw the whale too. And she spoke of that there was an open door on the ocean floor of God, on the ocean floor. That's how deep it was. And it spoke about how the door was open concerning the deep things of God. So we've seen that same thing. I'm telling you, man. Woo. And just like Bud said, I know each of us can tell, even now, of encounters or dreams or visions or whatever that God has shown us that have been really powerful. I know I have too. And I just exhort us to continue on and, in that. But let's frame this time. So Father, we just, and everybody popcorn, just flow. God, we just frame that we'll hit heaven's highest blueprint today. And Father, we agree to what we agreed upon for this day, for this time, back in the once was, that it come to full fruition. We choose to hit your bullseye today, for us today. And we thank you for all of the heavenly hosts' help to hit this bullseye. Wow, Father, we just enter into oneness with you and with wisdom, with the men in white linen, all the angels, the seven spirits, seven handmaidens. Father, thank you for all this help that's available to us now. And I think I said for us all that we are grateful. And I just feel even too, as just for even additional help to stay out of busyness. Lord, help us to stay to stay out of busyness, to stay still, and know that you are God, and know what that stillness looks like for each of us. And that we just simply stay there and do that and be what you show us we are. I'm getting even that even during this time we could be still and just allow transformation to happen.
I'm just going to say this. I see the rain. It's just such a beautiful, perfect rain falling. It's soft, gentle rain everywhere.
Don't even feel to say much. Let's just be still. Is that resonated with everybody?
Yes.
Yes.
Then let's just be still then. So Father, we just even take this time and we put you first and we choose to be still and be quiet and know that you're God. And receive all that you have for us. Thank you for rest, Father. Thank you for shalom. Does anybody want to share anything? We can just continue in the rest. Wow, that's a powerful time. Thank you, Father. Just encourage us all to put him first and to not be busy, and ask him, let him show you what that looks like for you, because it's different for everybody. It may look different for everybody. It's coming up on 5 till 5:30. Does anybody want to share anything before we go? And if you don't, that's fine. I just thought to give an opportunity if you wanted to. Awesome. Well, I can't say it'll be much to this recording. I'll put it up, somebody, it might help somebody. Thank you, ladies. We'll continue to stay in this position of rest, of shalom, of being still to receive, and whatever he wants to do, or whatever he wants to give us. And we receive this position, and we release it to all of the Ecclesia. This high and holy time. Thank you all. Have a great week, and we'll see you on the chats, okay? And in the other encounter groups.
Yes, okay, yes. Thanks. Love y'all.
Love you too, Lauren.
Bless you and love you guys.
Love and honor everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Thanks, Simone.
Absolutely.
Blessings. Blessings of rest.
Amen.